Please join in singing our opening hymn, Immaculate Mary, which can be found in your online worship aids.
Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God our Father, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
My sisters and brothers, we come into God's holy presence this morning, and we thank him for this beautiful solemnity of the Assumption of the Blessed Virgin Mary in heaven. And we know that the Lord is calling us also to heaven, little by little, day by day. And so where Mary is, we want to be. And so we pause and thank God for this great gift of eternal life that shines in on us during this Mass. And we renew our love for the Blessed Virgin Mary today and ask, first of all, through her intercession, the forgiveness of our sins. Lord Jesus, you are the Son of God and the Son of Mary. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you are the Good Shepherd calling us to eternal life. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you plead for us at the right hand of your heavenly Father. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Assume the Immaculate Virgin Mary, the mother of your Son, body and soul, into heavenly glory. Grant, we pray, that always attentive to the things that are above, we may merit to be sharers in her glory. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of Revelation. God's temple in heaven was opened, and the Ark of His covenant could be seen in the temple. A great sign appeared in the sky, a woman clothed with the sun, with the moon beneath her feet, and on her head a crown of 12 stars. She was with child and wailed aloud in pain as she labored to give birth. Then another sign appeared in the sky. It was a huge red dragon with 7 heads and 10 horns, and on its head were 7 diadems. Its tail swept away a third of the stars in the sky and hurled them down to the earth. Then the dragon stood before the woman about to give birth, to devour her child when she gave birth. She gave birth to a son, a male child, destined to rule all the nations with an iron rod. Her child was caught up to God and his throne. The woman herself fled into the desert where she had a place prepared by God. Then I heard a loud voice in heaven say, "Now have salvation and power come, and the kingdom of our God and the authority of his anointed one." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Brothers and sisters, Christ has been raised from the dead, the first fruits of those who have fallen asleep. For since death came through man, the resurrection of the dead came also through man. For just as in Adam all die, so too in Christ shall all be brought to life, but each one in proper order. Christ the first fruits, then, at his coming, those who belong to Christ. Then comes the end, when he hands over the kingdom of God to his Father and God, when he has destroyed every sovereignty and every authority and power. For he must reign until he has put all his enemies under his feet. The last enemy to be destroyed is death, for he subjected everything under his feet. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, Lord.
Mary set out and traveled to the hill country in haste to a town of Judah, where she entered the house of Zechariah and greeted Elizabeth. When Elizabeth heard Mary's greeting, the infant leaped in her womb. And Elizabeth, filled with the Holy Spirit, cried out in a loud voice and said, "Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb. And how does this happen to me, that the mother of my Lord should come to me? For at the moment the sound of your greeting reached my ears, the infant in my womb leaped for joy. Blessed are you who believe that what was spoken to you by the Lord would be fulfilled." And Mary said, "My soul proclaims the greatness of the Lord. My spirit rejoices in God my Savior, for he has looked upon his lowly servant. From this day, all generations will call me blessed. The Almighty has done great things for me, and holy is his name. He has mercy on those who fear him in every generation. He has shown the strength of his arm and has scattered the proud in their conceit. He has cast down the mighty from their thrones and has lifted up the lowly. He has filled the hungry with good things and the rich he has sent away empty. He has come to the help of his servant Israel, for he has remembered his promise of mercy, the promise he made to our fathers, to Abraham and his children forever." Mary remained with her about 3 months and then returned to her home. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
My soul proclaims the greatness of the Lord. My spirit rejoices in God my Savior. The words of our Blessed Mother to Elizabeth, her cousin, when they met, and both with child, Mary exclaimed very, very openly and joyfully that God was so gracious to her, and that Elizabeth, of course, knew that. And so Elizabeth greeted her also and said, "What joy I have to be in the presence of the mother of the Savior, and even the baby leapt in my womb for joy. So Mary is a woman of joy, realizing that God is so gracious to her. I think of the humility of Mary, how she had to be so humble before God, because she was really just a young person. She was a teenager. We believe that probably she was not more than 15 or 16 years old when the angel Gabriel spoke to her on this tremendous gift of God to her, to be the mother of the Savior. And sometimes I think, not that we forget, but maybe we take for granted that Our Lady, you know, we speak about her glory and about her, you know, glorious reign about us of Queen in heaven and earth, and that is all true. But we also have to remember that Mary was a human being like you and me, and that she was humble before God because she was in the presence of this almighty God, this mysterious God, this God of love. And Mary had to have that faith that what was said to her would be fulfilled, and that's what her cousin Elizabeth said. Blessed are you because you believed what was said to you would be fulfilled. And so Mary is a woman of faith, a woman of humility. And she says that in her Magnificat, I am the handmaid of the Lord. And I think when we recognize that we are full human beings that need God's grace every single day, every single moment of our day, in order to fulfill our life, to fulfill what God wants for us. I think of, in one sense, my own mother who, you know, led a life of, you know, very ordinary life, raising a family of four children. She, unfortunately, was called home kind of early in her life, only 67 years old, when she passed away. But I remember speaking to my mom as she was growing older, and I was asking my mom about, you know, her life. And it was a very, very challenging life, even as a young girl. She had to struggle in a lot of ways. She lost her father when she was a young girl, and she had other siblings. And I guess I think of her because I saw my mom so very humble about her life, and yet recognizing that God was always with her. I used to say, Ma, you know, what do you think? And she said, Billy, I'm just a old scrub woman. I never forget those words. She said, but I don't think I know that God blessed me with four good kids, a good husband, and I did the best I could do. And I saw that faith in my mom, and I believe that the Blessed Mother is saying that to us today. Yes, she's assumed into heaven. She is Queen of heaven and earth, and that is all true, and we know where she is, and we want to be there with her. But she's still a mother to us, and she knows what it's like to struggle, to be humble enough to know that we need God in our life. And Mary demonstrated that her whole life, that it was mysterious. Things happened to her that she didn't fully understand in a lot of times. She had to just go back to her reflection, everything in her heart, as a good mother would. She took everything and reflected on these things in her heart. That's what we are asked to do today, I think, for the Assumption, to celebrate God's graciousness to Mary, but also to realize that we're on the same path, maybe in a different way, a different vocation, but it's the same calling to eternal life with God, the happiness of being in heaven with Mary. When Mary appeared to Bernadette Soubirous, she said words that have always struck me because, first of all, we know that God wants us to be happy and joyful in our life, but we also know that this is not all of it. There is a heaven to be running for, waiting for, and to go toward that heaven. And so she said to Bernadette, I cannot promise you happiness in this life, only in the next. Now that was Bernadette's story, not maybe totally ours. But it is true that in the next life, our full happiness comes in. We can be happy here and have some real joy, but the joy is always being in Christ's presence, in the presence of the Blessed Mother with Jesus. And this is the closest we have of heaven right now, this Eucharist that we celebrate. This is a little bit of heaven on earth. It's just a glimpse, but it's saying where they are, we want to be. And Christ is saying, I'm coming into your presence. My very body and blood I am giving to you. And to let you know that this is heaven itself. And so today, the Church celebrates the magnificent gift that God has given to Mary, that she's body and soul
into heaven with her divine Son. And where she is, yes, we want to be. And yet we have to travel in this sometimes valley of tears. Not so easy. But it can be a life filled with joy also, because we know we're following Christ. We're trying to be like the Blessed Mother, faithful and humble in God's sight. And when we do that, I believe that the Lord will honor us also with eternal life. But we must be humble before God, knowing that we're still human, that we need His grace and His love every day of our lives. And then we have to send that love into the world around us. Because how many people are lacking joy today, are lacking, you know, any kind of happiness, because there's so much suffering in the world, so much violence. And we, as followers of Christ, followers of Mary, we're asked to give that joy, that love into the world that is lacking. So let's renew our love for the Blessed Mother this morning and ask her really the help to be joyful, to be humble, and to be faithful to God as she was every day of her life. God bless you.
Let us profess our faith. I believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through Him all things remain. For us men and for our salvation, He came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake He was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead. And His kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess my baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
Let us ask the Blessed Virgin Mary, who reigns in heaven for all eternity, to intercede on our behalf before the Lord.
That every generation in the Church call Mary blessed and look to her as a model of humble, faith-filled obedience, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For women around the world, that they may receive the honor and respect that is due to all children of God, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For continued healing and recovery of all those suffering from the coronavirus, for all who are homebound or suffering from chronic illness, for those impaired by addiction, for all who are close to death, for those who suffer alone, that they may be comforted by their faith and by those they love, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For young people, that they may respond generously and willingly if the Lord calls them to ordained or consecrated life, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the model of friendship we all seek be found in the love shared by Mary and Elizabeth, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all the prayers that we hold in the silence of our hearts, for those for whom we promise to pray, for those who have no one to pray for them by name, and for the intentions of those remembered in our parish bulletin, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
for the repose of the souls of Nunziante Giannasca, Cosmo and Nina Lachese, Angelo and Joe Vellante, Agnes Vandell, and James Jamie Holder, for whom this Mass is offered, for all our beloved dead, and for our own intentions. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And now we have the prayer for the year of St. Joseph. Saint, hail, guardian of the Redeemer, spouse of the Blessed Virgin Mary, to you God entrusted his only Son. In you, Mary placed her trust. With you, Christ became man. Blessed Joseph, to us too, show yourself a father and guide us in the path of life. Obtain for us grace, mercy, and courage, and defend us from every evil. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For today the Virgin Mother of God was assumed into heaven as the beginning and image of your church's coming to perfection, a sign of sure hope and comfort to your pilgrim people. Rightly, you would not allow her to see the corruption of the tomb, since from her own body she marvelously brought forth your incarnate Son, the author of all life. And so in the company of the choirs of angels, we praise you, and with joy we proclaim.
Thank you.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, giving thanks, broke it, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and once more, giving thanks, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the Blessed Apostle, St. Maria Goretti, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from heaven. to await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, peace I give you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And with your spirit.
Thank you.
Let us pray. Having received the sacrament of salvation, we ask you to grant, O Lord, that through the intercession of the Blessed Virgin Mary, whom you assumed into heaven, we may be brought to the glory of the resurrection, through Christ our Lord.
Amen. We have some announcements and reminders for you. Fully vaccinated people are no longer required to wear masks or socially distance in our churches. All non-vaccinated and partially vaccinated people are advised to continue wearing masks. Cardinal Sean has reinstated the Sunday Mass obligation. This obligation does not apply to those who are ill, to those who've been recently exposed to COVID or any other communicable disease, those who are confined to their homes or to hospitals or the other facilities due to illness, infirmity, frailty, or age, and those that are not yet able to be vaccinated due to age or any other health consideration. The Catholic Appeal Update. Thanks to all of our parishioners who have made a pledge to the 2021 Catholic Appeal Update. To date, our parish has pledged $60,730 towards our required fair share assessment of $69,000. Right now, we have only 87%. If you've not had a chance to make your gift, there's still time. Every gift makes a difference. Catholic Appeal envelopes are available at the front entrance of our churches, or you can go to www.bostoncatholic.com. and follow the prompts to Catholic Appeal to make your pledge. Registration for the September 12th Outdoor Welcome Back Mass and Barbecue has begun. So please visit our website to sign up and attend. And finally, as always, we thank you so much for your continued financial support to our parish. Please be sure to make all checks payable to Ave Maria Parish or sign up for online giving.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Mass is ended. We go forth in the peace and the joy of Christ.
Thanks be to God.
Please join in singing our closing hymn, Hail Holy Queen, which can be found in your online worship aids.